My role includes, interfacing with global financial services customers of HCL and talking to them about, data and technology, introducing them to our company and what we can do, and see how we can provide services which enable them to succeed in their business. Financial services technology has been evolving quite a bit. Technology and computers and financial services, have perhaps grown together over the last 40 years. So if you look at any financial services firm, data and analytics around data, whether it's simple interest calculation or whether it's tenor calculation, etc., has always been a part of financial services. So if you go back to the early days of computers, even the 60s and 70s, banks were one of the first industry to adopt technology. In the early years, the banks adopted technology largely for back office functions, record keeping, accrual programs, running interest rates. But that enabled a lot of bookkeeping to go into the technology and the computers in those years. And then later on, during the 90s, technology moved from back office services to middle office services. So decisions around credit, decisions around how you're going to kind of enhance the loan features, do things around the customer, around the data. Middle office functions in banks started getting automated and technology started coming to being. However, in the last 10 years, there has been a dramatic shift in the way technology has been consumed by the banks. And technology has become more front-end, right? So today, a lot of the millennial population, people who are the people who are now users of banking services and who are kind of now perhaps just start to earn, the way they consume banking technology is right from front to back, right? So for example, if you see today, most millennial people are used to services which are offered through Amazon or through Facebook or Google, where lots of services are offered on online devices. And therefore, when they look at a bank or they look at a financial institution, they expect that those services should also be provided front to back from, computer-aided devices. So people do not like to go to the branches anymore. People like to work more off, devices which are more omnipresent all over the place. And therefore, banking technology, therefore, has moved from many, many years back, which was largely back office record keeping, to later on middle office, a little bit more decision making, and now into front office, and in fact into the hands of the consumer. So that's been a dramatic change, and therefore the way technology is delivered to the customer, the way technology is grown in the financial service institution, in the banks, has also evolved in line with that. So one is, we have seen a lot of development of the front end technologies, right? So if the banks have got perhaps old legacy technology, then we've seen an entire focus towards APIs and opening up the banking data and data, et cetera, to consumers so that it can be consumed on an on-time basis. At the same time, as the data from the consumers is increasing because interaction now front to back happening through automated devices, there is a lot of focus on data analytics, so that the data which the banks are sitting with is now used for decision making. We are also seeing the growth of a lot of RPA and automation. So traditional services in the banks, which were done on the basis of manual processes, are getting automated. We are seeing that RPA, etc., happening there. We are also seeing a lot of emergence of the cloud. Traditionally, a lot of banking services were provided in in-house data centers, which were perhaps where the data was residing. We've seen the increased adoption of cloud. So we're seeing a lot of cloud-based services now coming up place. And as information goes into the cloud and into other environments, security becomes a big issue because banking is all about secure data, and therefore a lot of focus now on security. So I think these are the kind of trends that are taking place. There's more front end, there's more data, there's more analytics, there's more security, there's more cloud. And if I took a little bit long term, if I take a, let's say, 5 year and a 7 year kind of horizon, a little further down, I think we'll see increased use of IoTs, which will come into use in the financial services, especially in the insurance side. And on the banking technology side, blockchain and others will also become prevalent. So that's how it will perhaps evolve over the next couple of years as well. So the way HCL approaches the financial service market is that we provide services to our customers, and our customers tend to be global. So we deal with some of the largest financial service institutions in the world, who tend to kind of be in US, in Europe, in Asia, in the rest of the world, and so on and so forth. So they're present in multiple geographies. So number one is, we try and provide services, their technology service to them as their needs across the globe are growing and are emerging. Number two is that our customers are really facing two challenges. The one challenge they are facing is that they have to meet the growing technology needs of the millennial, right? So if you are servicing the millennial population, and as I mentioned earlier, the banks are redesigning products, etc., which are more available all the time to our customers. So we have also, as a service provider, changed the kind of services we offer. We offer more services which are now more mobile enabled, omni-channel enabled, and then around data analytics, you know, which enables better decision making to happen and better customer experience to happen from the end consumer's perspective. So we have remodeled a lot of our services. We have a strategy which is called the Mode 1, 2, 3 strategy. And the Mode 2 of our strategy is focused on providing such services to our customers, which is around digital, analytics, cloud, IoT, and security. So that's how we are providing services to our customer. At the same time, some of the largest banks that we deal with and the insurance companies we deal with also have a problem of legacy technology. The legacy technology is a large consumer of costs, okay, both from the point of your maintenance and regular upgrades from regulatory perspective, or even the large data centers that they have. So we are also working with lots of our customers in terms of re-looking at the cost base that they are having currently and seeing how we can improve the efficiency and productivity of the existing legacy technology, right? So through technology modernization, through moving some of the technology to the cloud, and through also other efforts such as automation and robotic process, etc., which can enable to cut the cost of the underlying technology. So we're helping our consumers both from point of view of helping cut costs, which is required today, as well as develop new technologies required from the end consumer's perspective. In effect, our strategy is about making our clients more efficient and more effective. The banks and financial institutions that we deal with today are facing tremendous amount of challenge from the, you know, both from the FinTechs as well as from the new age companies like the Amazons, Googles, etc. And we are, as a financial services technology provider, are trying to make sure that our clients have ability to develop technology exactly the way a technology company develops technology. And therefore, we want to kind of help our banks become more like technology companies in terms of the services that they're offering to their customers. That's how we are approaching the market.